Hello everyone, and welcome to the NUIG Dramsoc Drammies 2020 edition. If you didn't already know that, well, the next hour is probably not going to make a whole lot of sense to you. I'm Emily White, a former Dramsoc Productions officer, very nearly graduate of NUIG Dramsoc Weekly Stan account, and your host for tonight's proceedings. Now, for the uninitiated, the Drammies is sort of like a celebration for all of the various Dramsoc shows across the year, a place where we are able to look back on all the good times we've had and the achievements we've made, and to harshly judge the labors of our friends and peers and alienate those we do not deem to be talented enough. Now, the Drammies are looking a little different this year. Usually we'd be in our ancestral home, the Bank of Ireland Theatre, decked out in our formal wear, partaking in much merriment, whereas this year you are all watching this from your homes, and I am gesticulating in front of this dog that I found. But nevertheless, I, as your host, have taken a solemn oath to make sure this Drammy ceremony has exactly as much chaotic feral energy as you have all come to expect. Now, this moment is actually a really big deal for me. I'm so excited that I finally get the chance to be the one thing I've always wanted to be, a poor replacement for Evelyn Caffrey. No, but for real though, hosting the Drammies is actually really important for me. It's kind of all I've ever wanted for as long as I've been aware of the Drammies since they were founded, which, like, yeah, I guess was only 2 years ago, but that was still before most of our current first years were born. If you've ever attended the Drammies before, you know that the standard for hosting shenanigans is very high. And I intend, in my final act as a Dramsoc member, and honestly probably just my final act ever, depending on how some of these shenanigans go, to live up to the hype. Because, friends, I may not be talented. There was an end to that sentence. I may not be talented, but I can commit to a bit. So, you want jokes? You'll get jokes. You want incredibly specific Dramsoc-related roasts that only you'll be able to appreciate? You'll get those. You want an incredibly high production value musical number celebrating all the best moments of Dramsoc this year? Well, life is unfair, and you won't get what you want. But, like, I did bring some silly hats, so, you know, I'll probably put some silly hats on the dog. Now, the point of the Drammies is to celebrate all of this year's shows, and, oh man, you guys, the shows this year were fantastic. Like, I had such trouble filling out my voting card. Granted, that was mostly because all these shows were months ago and I have literally forgotten everything that happened in every single one of them. Like, whoever wins tonight, I'm just gonna be very happy for you, because I'm sure you did something to deserve it. But anyway, I decided to try and combat my clearly accelerated age-related memory loss tongue twister ability by going through all of the photos from this year's productions and trying to, like, reconstruct the basic plot based on just a photo from each production. I think I did pretty well. So I'm gonna just, like, take you through my findings. So this is from Much Ado About Nothing, and just kind of going on this picture, I think it's about a young male hurler who desperately wants to be in the school musical, but his friends want him to keep his head in the game. Next up we have Witness for the Prosecution, which is clearly about a man and how just, like, upset he is with his very small indoor fence. Okay, so in the scene from Medea, I think what they're going for here is the feeling of, like, when you wake up, your gap is a mess. Somebody's left a very dodgy looking bag behind and you realize that your landlord is going to be there in, like, 10 minutes. Now, okay, so going on, like, the setup, the lighting, and really just the general demeanor of everybody in this photo, I'm gathering what the effect is about is just the kinds of people you meet in the queue for the toilets in Electric. And then lastly, we have Disciples, which I don't remember anything about. But what I'm getting here is that it's actually just a true crime story about what Noel Minogue does to committee members who don't reach his standards. Obviously, these are the strangest of times that we find ourselves in, and I was really, like, struggling, racking my brains, trying to figure out the best way to talk, you know, sincerely from the heart about this experience, shared trauma that we're all enduring. And then Dramsoc made me sign this, like, perfectly legitimate contract about 5 minutes ago that basically forbids me from being at all sincere, emotional, or sentimental for the entire duration of tonight's show. So, nothing to worry about there, just some old-fashioned shitposting like our forefathers used to do. Now, one unintended consequence of this year's awards being online is that the reach is going to be quite different. Ordinarily, I would be delivering this monologue to a group of my beloved friends and peers in the BOI theater, just kind of saying things off the cuff, and to a group of people who would usually be quite merry by this point in the proceedings. However, this year the awards are going to be streamed online, and then the VOD, as I believe the children are wont to call it, will be available in perpetuity to be seen by anyone, including not just our society members, but also various college offices, bodies outside the college, and my parents. So, in the interest of best representing Dramsoc, the newly crowned best society in Ireland at BIX, I'll have you know, it was agreed that I should probably make a few amendments to my script, which is fine, you know, it's still gonna be the Drammies no matter what, but, you know, I just kind of wanted to pay tribute to some jokes that I worked really hard on but didn't get to see the light of day. So it's a goodbye to the Tiger King skit. That was pretty out of date anyway. Let's see here. Ranking committee members by their simp factor. That one could be construed as bullying, and we're not going to do that. Let's see. A mock in memoriam tribute to all of this year's strangest rap party hookups. There are so many reasons why we should not do that. Oh, and then of course, the pièce de résistance, the entire portfolio of jokes that I made about A Midsummer Night's Dream. I'm sorry, baby, you were the best of us. But that's okay, you know, it's just gonna be a night of family-friendly content, and that's fine. Also, this just in, apparently I'm not allowed to use my platform to demonstrate the correct way to administer a tampon, which I 100% was not planning on doing, but now that I've been told that I apparently can't, it's just a very compelling idea. But anyway, tonight is just a night where we can all use our platforms for good, you know, to be kind to each other, to celebrate each other's achievements, and just to take a large knife to anything that looks like it might be made of cake. So with all that out of the way, I think it's time we get into the awards proper. We're going to begin with some committee choice awards for, you know, small things like best duo, best scene, basically just things that the committee wanted to specifically award. Now, all of our awards this evening will be presented by our previous set of auditors, Noel Minogue and Oisin Fili, as well as Degrassi, The Next Generation, Richard Brown, and Aisling Hanrahan. So without further ado, I'm going to hand over for the Committee Choice Awards.
Hi everyone, my name's Aisling. I'm Vice Auditor this year, and I'm going to be presenting the Spirit of Dramsoc Award. Now this award is going to the production that really encapsulated the spirit of Dramsoc, the production that every single member worked really, really hard to get it on stage and just approached everything with enthusiasm and took part in every aspect of the production. And this is going to be going to the Freshers Plays, so Good Morning Kindergarten and Incisor Magazine. Congratulations.
Goodbye, goodbye, good friends, goodbye, 'cause now it's time to go. But hey,
hey guys, I'm Mark O'Connor. I am Dramsoc's head of tech for 2020 and 2021, and I'm here to announce the winners of some of the Committee's Choice Awards for the Drammies for 2019 and 2020. The first Committee's Choice Award I will be presenting is the Best Photo. So the winner of the Best Photo is the Medea cast photo. So well done to everyone in Medea. The photo looks amazing. Well done on that.
Hi guys. This year's award for Best Duo goes to a pair that's chemistry on stage was absolutely undeniable. And the Committee's Choice Award for Best Duo goes to Adam O'Connor and Hayley Delevoye for Into the Woods.
The spell is on our house.
Now tell me, what am I to return with?
Oh, you don't remember. The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure as gold.
The next award I will be presenting is the Best Visual in a Dramsoc show. And the winner of that goes to the visual of Tara hiding under the table during Much Ado About Nothing. It's a great photo, really made me laugh seeing it the first time, so well done on winning that.
The award for Best Scene goes to a scene that kept the audience members on the edge of their seats throughout. And the winner is Medea, for the scene in which Medea kills her children. Congratulations.
The next category I will be presenting is the Best Accents, and the winner of the Best Accents category for Committee's Choice is Good Morning Kindergarten. So well done for everyone who was involved in that show.
Goodbye, goodbye, good friends, goodbye, 'cause now it's time to go.
But the award for Best Delivery goes to someone who left audiences in awe. So the award for Best Delivery goes to Mark Fitzgerald for Leonard Vold's reveal at the end of Witness for the Prosecution. Well done.
Baby, I can't wait to know. What do you think about things? Believe it.
The next award goes to the goes towards Helping Hands, so someone who is just not necessarily involved in a cast or crew, just someone who is always there to lend a hand when Dramsoc needed it. And that award goes to Louise Hosty. So thank you very much, Louise, for everything that you've done for the society.
Best Newcomer is not an easy one to decide on. We're constantly seeing so much talent coming into Dramsoc every single year, and the dedication and commitment by every new member this year was amazing. So this year we've decided that there's not just one Best Newcomer, but three. So congratulations to Mark O'Connor, Serla Fenton and Chloe Naomi for being Dramsoc's Best Newcomers 2020.
And the next category I will be presenting is the Best Monologue. And the Best Monologue goes to the Brain Monologue, which was performed by Shannon O'Flynn in The Effect. So seriously, well done, Shannon. Very well deserved.
The award for Best Save goes to our very own theatrical superheroes that step in and save the day last minute. So the award for Best Save this year goes to Monster in the Hall for replacing the garbage last minute. Congrats, guys.
Next up, we have the award for Best Missing Dog. Now, this award goes to the... Is something...
That was really weird.
Huh, sure just can't. What were you saying?
Yeah, I'm really worried about Timmy. I feel like we've barely seen him since the whole Clara thing happened, and even when we do, he's just moping.
He's being really annoying.
Marty!
Well, oh, come on, he is.
So we should be helping him.
Sure, what can we do to help? I've tried to make him laugh loads, but everything just reminds him of her, and it makes me want to vomit.
That's because you've never been in love.
Look what love did to Timmy.
Anyways, I've been thinking of a way that we could distract him. And, well, I need you to tell me if this is too crazy. But, you know, Luna?
Timmy's dog.
Mm-hmm. Timmy's obsessed with her. She's with him 24/7.
So?
So, what if she wasn't anymore?
What?
I'm seeing that we take her.
Steph.
No, listen. We take her, we leave her at yours, and we leave a ransom note. Make Timmy think that she's been kidnapped. And he'll completely forget about Clara. It'll work, I am sure of it.
You are bonkers.
Come on, you know it is a good idea.
Of course it is. I'm just annoyed I didn't think of it first.
So this is the plan then.
How much is that doggy in the window? The one with the waggly tail.
So now we're going to move on to our main categories voted on by you, the society membership. This is basically your chance to have your say about all the best moments, performances, and technical achievements across all of this year's shows. Everyone except for me, of course, because I have like an inherent inability to recognize culture. It's just a thing people from Dublin have, it really sucks. But anyway, we're gonna move into an award now. I don't know which one, because I haven't gotten a running order, so let's just say Best Poster.
The nominations for Best Poster are Oisin Parslow for A Midsummer's Night Dream, Oisin Parslow for Disciples, Conor Keogh and Oisin Doyle for The Effect, and Aisling Hanrahan for Much Ado About Nothing. And the winner is Oisin Parslow for A Midsummer's Night Dream.
As you may have seen, there have been a few changes to the performance categories for this year's Grammys. Firstly, all categories are now gender neutral, which is great. Secondly, we decided to divide performances on the basis of whether or not they are comedic or dramatic. And this got me thinking, you know, Dramsoc, they put on such a variety of different kinds of shows every year that I thought it would be great to put a spotlight on just all of the different styles that Dramsoc is capable of doing. So, I devised a few of my own subcategories for this purpose, so we're just gonna run through those kind of quick. Best historical would be this year's historical win for Best Society at BIX. Hell yeah. I'm just gonna put that. Best crime of the year would be the result of Dramsoc versus Gum's Family Feud. So I'm not over that. Best sports. I have nothing written. Kind of weird that. Oh no. Best musical goes to Kips, the new Half a Sixpence musical. There's no joke there, just like, I thought Kips was class. I'm just losing all of these. Wow, okay. There's a metaphor here. Best fantasy goes to a liberal government in Ireland. Nice, not very topical, like 6 months ago. Best horror goes to that sandwich that you left in your locker on the 12th of March. It's still there. It's grown legs. Yeah. Best comedy, of course, goes to NUIG for their handling of the repeat fees. And last but not least, best tragedy. Someone's just drawn a picture of my face. I don't know why that's there. I need to clean myself up. Let's do the performance categories.
Hey everyone, my name is Richard, and I have the honour of announcing our Outstanding Actor in a Dramatic Role. The nominations are Anna Cooney as Medea in Medea, Brian O'Hanrahan as Joe Pitt in Angels in America Part 1, Millennium Approaches, Anna Cooney as Harper Pitt in Angels in America Part 1, Millennium Approaches, Conor McLaughlin as Puck in A Midsummer Night's Dream, Robbie Walsh as Prior Walter in Angels in America Part 1, Millennium Approaches, and Matty Loane as Tristan in The Effect. Our runner-up for this category is Robbie Walsh as Prior Walter in Angels in America Part 1 Millennium Approaches. And our winner is, drumroll please, Matty Lone as Tristan in The Effect.
And the nominees for Outstanding Actor in a Comedic Role are Tara Spelman as Beatrice in Much Ado About Nothing, Claudia Glavy as Little Red Riding Hood in Into the Woods, Ari Batty as Hero and Dogberry in Much Ado About Nothing, Mark O'Connor as Bottom in A Midsummer Night's Dream, and Ferdia Manning as Roy Cohn in Angels in America Part 1 Millennium Approaches. And the runner-up is Mark O'Connor as Bottom in A Midsummer Night's Dream. And the winner is Ferdia Manning as Roy Cohn in Angels in America Part 1 Millennium Approaches.
Again, don't know where. The nominations for Outstanding Supporting Actor in a Dramatic Role are Tara Spelman as Chorus in Medea, Maddie Carpenter as Ensemble in Disciples, Rachel Gowen as Clara or Ensemble in Disciples, Cora Mae White as Snug in A Midsummer Night's Dream, Ikenna Anyabuke as Belize or Mr. Lies in Angels in America Part 1 Millennium Approaches, and Tyler Villa as Umbrella Man in Disciples. The runner-up is Ikenna Anyabuke as Belize or Mr. Lies in Angels in America Part 1 Millennium Approaches. And the winner is Tyler Villa as Umbrella Man in Disciples. Baby, don't hurt me no more.
Baby, don't hurt me. Nominations for Outstanding Supporting Actor in a Comedic Role are Molly Fahey as Hannah in Angels in America, Oisin Doyle as Mysterious Man in Into the Woods, Oisin Parslow as Rapunzel's Prince in Into the Woods, Sinead Ryan as Peter Quince in A Midsummer's Night Dream, and Norman Ogg as Joe in Disciples. The runner-up is Sinead Ryan as Peter Quince in A Midsummer's Night Dream, and the winner is Norman Ogg as Joe in Disciples.
Now we move to the award that we probably all need the most coming out of lockdown. Best Hair and Makeup.
The nominations for Best Hair and Makeup are Jesse Larkin, Hannah Poppy Bowl, and William Richards for A Midsummer's Night Dream, Tessa Crowe, Quinlan Nicomley, Sarah Fenton, and Louise Hossey for Into the Woods, Heather Flanagan for The Effect, and Tessa Crowe for Angels in America. And the winner is Jesse Larkin, Hannah Poppy Bowl, and William Richards for A Midsummer's Night Dream.
To the award for Best Costume. Now, the standard costuming across this year's shows has been incredible, just absolutely fantastic. So, I decided to add my own little spice to this category, you know, my own little prize. Whoever wins Best Costume is entitled to one silly hat from my silly hat collection. Now, this prize is in fact non-negotiable, and if you do not give me a mailing address, I will hunt you down in the dead of night and give you a hat anyway. Good luck.
And the nominees for Best Costume are Mae O'Connell, Justine Pepin, and Alison Dixon for A Midsummer Night's Dream, Keen Elwood and Michael Healy, The Effect, Aisling Hanrahan and Neil McHugh, Into the Woods, Jodie Finn, Lucy Birmingham, Dervla Melia for Incisor Magazine and Good Morning Kindergarten. And the winner is Mae O'Connell, Justine Pepin, and Alison Dixon, A Midsummer Night's Dream.
Now, I'm going to be real to you. There are some times when it all gets to be a bit much, and sometimes I'll be asleep and I'll be dreaming of just something terrible, just the absolute worst. And then I wake up all alone in the dark, wiping a cold sweat from my brow and just kind of trying to quiet myself down, you know, saying, it's okay, you're okay, it's all over now, it's fine. You never have to go back to Into the Woods, Tech. And then somewhere deep in the dark and deathly still corner of my room. Hear the familiar, discordant notes of a flute. Let's talk about sound design.
So the next award, guys, is Best Sound Design. And the nominations are Ariane Batty for A Midsummer Night's Dream, Georgina Bashford for Angels in America Part 1, Millennium Approaches, Patrick Keneally for The Effect, and Jess Harkin for Witness for the Prosecution. And the winner is Ariane Batty for A Midsummer Night's Dream.
From our regularly scheduled awards now, we actually have the addition of a new category very late in the game, this being the award for Best Voiceover Performance in a Dramsoc Show. Now, since this was a very last-minute addition, I'm just going to present this one, so I hope the auditors don't mind. It's on a bit of paper because envelopes are a scam. That's why. The nominees are Emily White in Disciples. Okay, yeah, solid pick. Let's see here. Emily White in Into the Woods. I can see that, yeah. Megan Jane Devlin in Angels in America Part 1. And the Drammy goes to, well, this is so exciting, I haven't got the chance to do this yet. Megan Jane Devlin in Angels in America Part 1. That's great. I'm just so happy for you, MJ. Love ya. We're gonna do... let's do Best Movement and Choreography now.
The nominations for Best Movement / Choreography are Ariane Batty for A Midsummer's Night Dream, Niamh Francis for Into the Woods, and Muireann Dauthney for Disciples. The winner is Ariane Batty for A Midsummer's Night Dream.
Stage managers, what do they even do? Well, they handle forms, they remind you to eat, and most of all, their collective, only functional adult in the building energy is enough to power the theater industry worldwide. Let's give it up for the stage managers.
Okay, so I have the honor of announcing our Best Stage Management. As you guys know, stage management is so important to any play, so congrats to all the stage managers for all our productions this year. It's a tough job, but you guys clearly did your job since all the plays went on, so it's great. Our top nominations for Best Stage Management. The nominations are Ailish McDonough and Aisling Hanrahan for A Midsummer Night's Dream, Kira Toll for The Monster in the Hall, Orla Mulcahy for The Effect, and Megan O'Neill, James Boylan and Katie Feeney for Angels in America Part 1, Millennium Approaches. And the winner is Ailish McDonough and Aisling Hanrahan for A Midsummer Night's Dream.
Right, next up we are moving on to the award for Best Set. Now, I have a lot of respect for people who do set. I think it's a very intensive, often very thankless job. So I'm just really happy to have this award here to recognize the people who do set. And one thing about doing sets is that it can be kind of intimidating to get started with, but, you know, absolutely you should not let that hold you back at all. That's why if you have any questions about doing set whatsoever, you should tweet Dramsoc Head of Sets Ushin Parslow. He will answer any question about sets any day, any hour of any day, and he just really thrives on answering tedious questions. Oisin Parslow does sets. Do not believe the slander. Best set.
So if you saw any of the shows this year, guys, you would know how incredible are all the set designs and the set construction was for all our productions. So without further ado, here are the nominations for Best Set. Conor McGowan, Vinnie McBrien, and Patrick Fogarty for Zugzwang. Chloe Naomi, Matthew Brown, Mark O'Connor, and Aoife Lannan for The Monster in the Hall. MJ Devlin and Ross Gibbons for Angels of America Part 1 Millennium Approaches, and MJ Devlin for The Effect. And the winner is Conor McGowan, Vinnie McBrien, and Patrick Fogarty for Zugzwang.
Each morning a missionary advertises with neon sign. He tells the native population that's
it. Now we move on to the award for Best Original Script. Now, personally, I was a little bit disenchanted that my own personal pet project, my grimdark, edgy reboot slash adaptation of Good Morning Kindergarten, tentatively titled Dramsoc Weekly Origins, was not deemed an acceptable entry, as it had not and will never be produced. That said, this is a great category and hopefully provides some kind of incentive for you guys to submit your own work for Dramsoc, because, and being completely honest here, putting on original work with Dramsoc is like literally the coolest thing ever, and this is getting way too close to being sincere. So we're just gonna move on to the award.
The nominations for Best Original Script are Patrick Fogarty for Zugzwang and Emily White for Disciples. And the winner is Patrick Fogarty for Zugzwang.
That civilization is a thing for me to see.
Now, obviously, there's been a lot of uncertainty to do with things to do with the upcoming academic year, various courses, how much of it will be digital learning, how much will be face-to-face, and then sort of the knock-on effects of that of, well, do we actually need to be renting accommodation, or is it just a waste of money? And, you know, everything's very uncertain, and really there's no correct answer to that. So that's why a couple friends and I have devised a plan that we're just going to take all the constituent elements of the Zugzwang set and just live in the crawl space above the tech box in the BOI. We're still taking applications for roommates, so if anybody's interested, just hit us up. Speaking of the tech box, segues. Speaking of tech, let's do Best Lighting Design.
The nominations for Best Lighting Design are Conor McLaughlin for The Effect, Matthew Brown for A Midsummer Night's Dream, Michaela O'Sullivan for Angels in America Part 1 Millennium Approaches, and Conor McLaughlin for Disciples. And the winner is Conor McLaughlin for The Effect.
Next up, we have the award for the show that did the best job hyping people up and convincing all of our relatives on Facebook that investing all of your time in a college drama society is actually a perfectly reasonable and worthwhile thing to do. It's Best Promo Campaign.
The nominations for Best Promo Campaign are Angels in America Part 1, Millennium Approaches, The Monster in the Hall, Much Ado About Nothing, and Into the Woods. And the winner is Angels in America Part 1, Millennium Approaches.
Again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet.
Okay, you guys, we're into the home stretch. And by home stretch, I mean my phone is about to run out of battery, so let's keep barreling along. It's Best Director.
And the nominees for Best Direction are Ariane Bashi, A Midsummer Night's Dream, Oisin Doyle and Claudia Glavy, The Effect, Richard Brown and Kira McAvoy, Angels in America, Part 1, Millennium Approaches, and Sirica de Fricha, Much Ado About Nothing. And the winner is Ariane Bashi, A Midsummer Night's Dream.
Now on to Best Ensemble, celebrating the most charismatic, cohesive, and chemistry-filled casts of this year who managed to coexist and coagulate in contentment and did not cause the crews to coordinate a coup against them. Don't know why I decided to alliterate that. Best Ensemble!
And the nominees for Best Ensemble are Angels in America, Part 1, Millennium Approaches, A Midsummer Night's Dream, The Monster in the Hall, and The Effect. And the winner is Angels in America, Part 1, Millennium Approaches.
Smiling through, just like you always do, till the...
Alright, this is it, y'all. The big one. Best production. Now, obviously, it should go without saying that all of this year's productions were of an incredibly high standard, and you should all be very proud of everything that you achieved this year. We would give this award to everyone if we could, but unfortunately that would not make for a very narratively satisfying ending. So let's just find out what the people have chosen.
And the nominees for Best Production are A Midsummer Night's Dream, Angels in America Part 1, Millennium Approaches, The Effect, and Zugzwang. And the winner is A Midsummer Night's Dream.
And that's it for Drammies 2020. Huge congratulations, of course, to all of our winners and nominees this evening. So I want to say a huge thank you to both our outgoing and our incoming committees for making this show happen, presenting, editing, organizing, facilitating the votes. There were a lot of people who did a lot of actual work for this. I just showed up and bapped to a camera. So I just want to say thank you so much to everybody who made this happen. You know what? That's right. Sentimental Emily time. This year has gone ways that none of us really could have expected, and I mean that on several levels. It has been one of the most unique years I feel safe in saying Dramsoc has ever experienced. But also one of the best. We don't know what the immediate future holds for this society, but we do know one thing. If you keep coming to our shows, you keep engaging, you keep showing us that there are shows that you want to see, then we'll keep doing them. Because at the end of the day, it's not, you know, the award winners, or the committee, or anyone, you know, people who dress like this and then present award shows who make Dramsoc what it is. It's all of you. So on that note, I want to say thank you for virtually being here tonight. Stay safe. And stay silly.